Welcome, student, to the second part of the geography first chapter. So if you have not gone through the first chapter, you can go to that chapter. The chapter is being uploaded in the playlist. Okay, and if you want to get the latest notification, you can subscribe to the channel. So student, today we will be learning about the topic, that is Earth as a planet. Okay, so let's get started. So students, Earth, it is a round object, right? And it moves around the sun in the space, okay, and it belongs to the solar family, okay, and it moves around the sun in a fixed path that we call it as orbit, right? Okay, so the Earth, if we talk about the Earth as an oblate spheroid, what does it mean? So Earth as an oblate spheroid, it means that the shape of the Earth is not spherical, okay, that is, it is bulge at the equator and flatten at the poles. Okay, student? And this can be proved from the fact that if you see the diameter of the equator, it is 12,756 km. But if we talk about the polar diameter of the Earth, it is 12,714 km. Okay, that means we can see the difference in between the diameter of the diameter at the equator and the diameter at the poles. So the difference in diameter, this proves that Earth is not a perfect sphere, right, student? And why does there is a change in the diameter of the Earth? This is because the greater diameter of the Earth at the equator, it is due to the centrifugal force, okay, right? Because of the rotation that takes place, the Earth rotates at a great speed. Okay, so at the center, that is the equator, which forms a bulge at the equator, okay, and compression at the poles, and hence it is not a perfectly spherical. Okay, the Earth is not perfectly spherical. It is somewhat like, you know, a spheroid. It is not sphere. Oblate spheroid, right, students? Okay, now we will talk about the Earth as the home of humankind. Student, as you know that the Earth is the only planet so far discovered, okay, because the discoveries goes on and on, and by far we know the existence of life only it is visible in the planet, that is the Earth. Sorry. Right, students? So, the Earth, it is the only planet that supports the life. Okay? And it is covered with the enormous blue-green oceans, the vegetations. Okay? There are millions of islands, the rivers, huge masses that are called continents. Okay? And the ice caps and deserts, etc. and etc. Okay, so in all part of the Earth, there are some form of life. Okay, so if we talk about the Earth, some form of life exists in all part of the Earth. Okay, so if we see from the coldest part to the poles, to the warmest part of the equator, Earth, it has certain feature that make it a habitable planet. Okay, what is habitable planet? Habitable planet means it is, you know, it is suitable for the life, and it provides the certain conditions so that the survival of the, you know, living beings is possible. And this is how it is a unique planet. Okay, right, students? So what are the things that make it the home of the humankind, or the, you know, the possibility of survival is on the planet? So we will deal one by one. The first thing is distance from the sun. So students, if you talk about a distance from the sun, the Earth is at the third farthest point from the sun. Okay, after Mercury and Venus, it is at the third point. Okay, it is having the third place after the Mercury and the Venus. Okay, and it is at the optimum distance. Okay, enough of the distance so that it is neither too cold, not too hot. Okay, so the difference between the not a difference, it's a distance. Okay, so distance between the sun and the earth, it is enough. Okay, and enough for what? For making the possibility of life, for the existence of life on the earth. Okay, and if it would be little closer to the sun, then the life would get burned, isn't it? Because of the enormous heat of the sun. And if it would be farther from the sun, then life would be freeze because of the, you know, scarcity of the heat. Right, student? So it is at the optimum distance from the sun. Now next is temperature. So students, as we have talked that it is at the optimum distance from the sun, that means it is having, you know, the correct, it received the correct amount of heat. Okay, and if we talk about the planet, that is Earth, the average temperature, the average temperature of the Earth is 17 degrees Celsius. Okay, that means it is suitable for the life to exist. Okay, and if the average temperature of the Earth, it just changes by the few degrees, that would enable the, you know, the perishing of many of the species, right? Okay, students, because the change in the temperature would have, you know, the average temperature would have an adverse effect on the life of the species. Okay, and they would be perishing. Hence the temperature of the earth is, you know, the average temperature of the earth is like that, which enables the survival of the life. Okay, if you talk about the Venus, although it is the second planet from the sun, but it is hotter than the Mercury. Okay, though the Mercury, it is closest to the sun, but the Venus is much more hotter than the Venus. The Venus is much more hotter than the Mercury. And why? This is because the atmosphere of the Venus, it contains the gases like carbon dioxide. Okay, and the carbon dioxide, it produces the greenhouse effect. Okay, what does it produce? It produces the greenhouse effect on the surface of the Venus, and hence the temperature of the Venus, it remains very high. Okay, students, so the Earth atmosphere, it contains the small amount of carbon dioxide, which makes the Earth a habitable planet, so that the survival of the living beings can be possible. Okay, students. Okay, so now proceeding forward, the next thing is we will study about the Earth as a home of the humankind, that is its atmosphere. So the Earth atmosphere, it contains a mixture of gases like carbon dioxide, oxygen, and large amount of nitrogen, and, you know, traces of helium, argon, that are less than 1%, etc. and etc. Okay, so the atmosphere, it receives the heat from the sun in the form of the radiation. Okay, that is solar radiation, and it loses the heat in the form of radiation. Okay, so this is how the balance is maintained in the Earth atmosphere, right, student? And the ozone that is present in the atmosphere, it absorbs the harmful ultraviolet rays. You know how harmful the ultraviolet rays are, okay? Because they can be very, very, very harmful. Understood? They can be very, very harmful if they, you know, enters or they passes through the atmosphere and, you know, reaches us. But ozone, it is being absorbed by the Earth atmosphere, in the Earth atmosphere, and hence the rays of the sun, that is the ultraviolet harmful radiation, they don't reaches us. Okay, student. And the atmosphere also prevent the loss of the heat. Okay, it don't allow all of the heat of all of a sudden to escape out from the Earth. Okay, and hence it helps the temperature to be maintained and keeps the earth warm so that the temperature of the earth could be, you know, it could be enough so that the life could be sustained. Right, student? Okay, so the next thing that we will be studying is water. So the earth, if we talk about the earth is a blue planet. Okay, and why it is called a blue planet? Because 70% of the earth, it is covered with the water. Okay, although the potable water, it's, you know, percentage is very very low, but if we talk about the water only, okay, it is about 70%. So the water distribution, it is responsible and enables the climate of the earth to be moderate, okay, and hence it maintains the surface condition of the earth. Right, student? And the availability of water on the earth's surface, it can be seen like, you know, seas, rivers, lakes, you know, ponds, etc. Okay, so these are the, you know, these are the sources, and the mighty glaciers, isn't it? So these are the sources, okay, of the water. So what happens is the water evaporates into that atmosphere, you know, and again in the form of, you know, the process goes on and on, then the condensation, then the precipitation, you know, the hydrological cycle takes place. So water, you know, it regulates inside the earth, okay, and makes us, and this is, you know, very 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 essential part of the life, for the survival of the life on the planet. Okay, students. So next is solid crust. Solid crust, also called as lithosphere, okay, the solid part of the earth crust. So earth, it has a solid crust that we known as the, called as a lithosphere. So students, due to the weathering of the rocks, okay, breaking and disintegrating of the rocks into small particles, and you know, due to the weathering of the rocks, the surface of the earth has been formed, and it provides the soil, okay, and this layer, it supports the plant life on the earth. Okay, so the soil, it provides the various nutrients that are necessary for the plant growth, isn't it? And which in return, it supports all the form of the animals or the, you know, plants and various directly or the indirectly, right? Okay, now the next, it is biosphere. So what does this mean? Biosphere, the life zone. So what is biosphere? The biosphere, it is a narrow realm. Okay. Likewise, it is like a interaction whereby the atmosphere, the hydrosphere and the lithosphere. Okay. So this is the perfect, you know, the condition for the survival of the life or the habitats. Okay. Because here, all the essentialities that are required for the species to live, they are here. Okay, the light, water, food, you know, heat, everything. So this is an integral part, right, student? So if we talk about the biosphere, what is it? Biosphere, it is a thin layer of approximately 15 kilometers, okay, and it extends from the highest mountain peak to the deepest ocean, right, student? And if we talk about the ground level, it extends to the depth of like 3 meters below the ocean water and about 200 meter deep, where the marine and the fresh water life is found. Okay, correct. So within the biosphere, we can see the life in two forms. Either they can be in the form of plant kingdom, or secondly in the form of animal kingdom, right, students? So in this video, we will go up to here only, and in the next part 3 of this video, we will be dealing with the various life-giving cycles. Okay, Till then, keep revising, keep learning, be inside and be safe.